hard to say whether it's love or admiration or what, because the insects are always a fulfilling part of my life. They always have been since I was a little kid, and I just take it to the next levels by working in jobs that were about insects. They are so fascinating from every aspect, whether it's their biology, their behavior, and their behaviors are off the charts with things that they do. So I always pick up those weird behaviors that I can use when I'm giving presentations. But then the beauty of them was just so incredible. If you stop to look, wow, it's the colors of the rainbow. The main bathroom is the room that we decided to use as a display for all the insect art. Because I used to have it in a room that I worked in all the time, but nobody ever could see it. So my wife said, oh, put them all up in the bathroom. So I said, okay. So then people can come in here and cringe maybe, or just enjoy it, because it's neat. And is there a favorite? Hard to pick a favorite of art things, just like picking a favorite bug do you have, and I don't, because they're all so interesting to me. The one with a huge antennae, exceedingly long, is called a weta, and that's a New Zealand cricket, if you will, almost the size of my hand, the real ones. And so this one is essentially life-sized. Even though I retired from the entomology department at the U of A in 2013, I still like to come in and do volunteer work in the collection. We changed it all over right about when I was retiring, and so there's still plenty of work to do. It allows me to keep my fingers in the subject, but also it gives me a chance to interact with colleagues that worked in the collection like I am, which is volunteering and learning more about things that they love. You know, the insect world is one of the, wow, I'm always feeling alive when I'm doing it. And with singing, it just brings out even more of that life. It just makes you feel so good at performing. And then, you know, I don't do a lot of solos or things like that. I fit into the choir, and so it's nice blending with all of these people. And in that way, I take the joy of bugs, and I can actually enjoy the people that I'm hanging out with, because they're doing things that I like too. I still get calls from a lot of different groups to come and give presentations. And the Green Valley group was a garden club. And I'd been down, oh, a few years before, I think, and gave them a talk. And so they invited me back. I guess they like me. I hope. Because it's always fun to come and, again, educate the public. Unfortunately, the things that get taught are fear and paranoia of bugs. The only fear that I might put out is the stupid poisons that too many people use to take away life. And that's the attitude in so many places. We don't want to have nature. We want to have something artificial. But what do the ants do? Wow, they're incredible. And so you have to get over this fear of bugs, because they're not out to kill you. They're really out to make our lives that much better. They fulfill so much in our community. If we got rid of them, our community wouldn't survive. So that's a big goal of mine, is to continue to teach. It's my life. You know, if there's one thing that's been a constant, it's been the joy of insects.